Hi guys. Okay, so hopefully you can hear me. What am I seeing over here? What is that? Oh, okay. I have you. Everybody's sleeping. Okay, so I have you in my headphones. So I hope you can hear me. A little bit. So I'll be back tomorrow, but I'm gonna do a quick one for you to see what just the vibe is today, okay? I might be on a little bit, I don't know, right? So anyhow, good morning, good morning, good morning. It's Monday, all day, September 9th. Monday, all day. So your sleeping better, you're coming out of anxiety, you know, and your fears are the best of you. We do have a situation here with all six of swords being reversed, though. This is a lesson on looks right now could be karmic fear, working past it. If you're confused about something, I think you're going to figure out what direction to go. Right now, he is still up in the air. I'm not seeing something, you know how this works when my spirit doesn't give me cards unless I see. So there's something I'm not seeing. You know, someone is on the verge of learning an important lesson, right? Because with the Six of Swords upright, you're moving away from the lesson. You're learning it. You learned it. It was harsh. So you're just in the midst of it. So there's an offer about to be presented to you. It could be something that's coming back around, something you once offered to somebody. It might not be the same person offering it, but it's some type of offer. So, someone I think was worried to move something forward, to offer something to someone, but I see that dissipating. So it looks like it's an offer that's about to come around. I think someone's been avoiding just talking about whatever this is, whatever offer this is, whatever comes next. It's got to be a big deal, because that card's a big deal. But the beautiful thing is that it's about to be conquered. Okay. So we have the Nine of Cups. The Princess of Pentacles reversed. At the bottom of the deck we have the King of Pentacles. So you could be dealing with a Virgo. You could be dreaming about a situation. I think with the Princess of Pentacles being reversed, you're really going to have to go within soul search. Whatever this offer is. It's definitely going to require time. It definitely looks like it has to do with your finances, it's Pentacles. I think this Hermit is the King of Pentacles. About to make an offer to you that's going to be happy, or this Virgo energy is trying to make you happy. It's just, I don't know if you're going to take it the right way, even though it looks like they have great intent, because King of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck and it's upright. It's an amazing king. And the Virgo, you know, the Hermit energy is a teacher, it's wisdom, it's knowledge, higher knowledge. It's spiritual too, right? But the Hermit soul searches. They want to make you happy. And I just don't know how you're going to respond. So that seems to be a situation for the next day or two. And with the Six of Swords being reversed, this seems to be the Hermit's lesson. So this is either you guys, the Princess of Pentacles, or you're the Hermit, or King of Pentacles. I don't think this offer is going to be a familiar offer, though. But it's, I don't know if it's something you're waiting on. The Hermit's being strategic. There's something with logistics here, too. I don't know what that's about. Because I'm feeling the King of Swords energy, even though it's not out. So let's, I don't know what you're gonna do. It's not a bad thing. The offer looks legitimate. Yeah, see what I'm saying? Two of Swords, you have to make a decision. Whatever this offer is in the next day or two. But this person, this Virgo or Cappy energy, it could be work too, guys. But this Virgo Cappy energy, they're the ones making some type of offer to you. But this is good because they were stressed out about it, but they're not really stressed out about it anymore, but they still don't know. It's almost like they're getting offered an opportunity. But you play part of that opportunity somehow. They just want to make you happy. They're very strategical So that's not even a word. Strategic, right? But like strategical, that's not a word. I quite made it a word, you know me. I make up my own words. So that's the word of the day, okay? Now tell me about the Six of Swords. It could have to do with travel. I mean, they're on a boat, right? So you got the Page of Swords reversed. See, this person wasn't ready to say something to you. And it's the Prince, right? But man, do they have a freaking killer horse. I wonder where their stallion is. It could be air. Or it could be Virgo. Something to do with their Mars here, too. Okay? But they haven't talked about it yet, but they're going to. That's just it, like, they had to get over this fear, whatever this is. They had to get out of confusion. So they're not confused about something. So it's a good thing. They just haven't talked about it yet. And this is that Capricorn Virgo. But see what I'm saying? They're coming as a page because they don't know how to present this. But that's not a bad thing, folks. It's all about the Four Cups. Whatever they're about to offer, they just want to make you happy. So this person is just coming out of anxiety. So this person, it could be a money offer, some type of work offer, some type of adventure. She's standing in foreign lands. I'm not really sure what this is about. But see how they're hesitating because the Fool is reversed. They're like, will she take a leap of faith? Will I take a leap of faith? The Virgo, right? The Fool Angel. This is not saying that they do not have faith. This is saying, how will this person feel? Because right now, it's up in the air because no one's talking about it. But this offer, they're pretty confident. And I'm thinking it might have to do with money, travel, foreign land, something. Because this is the Fool. They go wherever. They take a leap of faith. They're ready to take a leap of faith. The offer's coming. They're going to offer it. And they're pretty confident. So you're dealing with somebody who's reliable, stable, confident. In a power position. For sure. Work, home, relationship, wherever they play that role. They're just coming out extremely stable cards. I think someone might be worried about your reaction or you leaving a situation. Tell me about the Princess of Pentacles. This is the Hermit's energy. Five of Pentacles reversed. And this was at the bottom of the deck. That's why I said what I had just said. Because that was under the Fool anyway, right? So it's like, with the Strength card being reversed, she actually has a little bit of fear. She's not uncomfortable. She's not lonely. This might help her finances, but I don't think that's what this is about. With all these pentacles, it is about stability, something reliable. I just don't know how she's going to feel. I don't know if something's going to be like lack of comfort. It's almost like something's... It's like the offer's going to be good, right? But it's almost like it's not about the finances to this one, if it's linked to finances. And I think it is. Whether it's hers, him, work, I don't know. But I don't know if she's going to look at it like... Like, you think money's going to solve the problem? Because she's not about it. See what I'm saying? Coming in as the pencil, but she's not about it. I mean, money's nice, guys, right? We all gotta pay our bills. But she's also addressing some type of fear with the Leo card being here. This is not gonna be like, I'm gonna make my decision right away. Tell me about the slide. This is somebody that's feeling good. If there's money issues, there's no money issues now. Okay, so this is somebody who wants to come in and help lay the weight down. So it is going to lay the weight down. Because it's reversed. Someone's going to fight for you. There's something where you're going to stand here, or you're going to be guided. But I don't think... That's what it's saying. It's like, you're gonna be guided. Because yes, this situation will help. But I think you might take it. So make sure you're talking about whatever this is. You know what I mean? Sorry, the sun's like right there. Maybe if I go down a little bit, try turning it down. Green is not so bad. Does that help a little bit? Yeah. So this is not a bad thing. It's a good thing, but you're gonna be. Because it's almost like I don't know, I'm just gonna leave it at this. All I know is that this offer that's gonna come in it's gonna help you lose some weight. But I don't know how this energy over here is going to take it. So make sure you talk about it. If there's something that bothers you. Don't jump in the first opportunity. Necessarily without really thinking it through, right? I'm not saying don't take it. I'm just saying think it through. Maybe it's for you, maybe it's not. This Fool energy is about having a brand new start, new opportunities, creating, taking a leap of faith. They're more worried about how you're going to take this offer. going to talk about it. So Seven of Swords reversed. Okay, so this is not, it's not a bad thing. It's not manipulation. It's not deception. It's a little tricky though. Whatever this is, I just don't think it's going to solve all the problems. Max just tried to come over here and Lucy stopped him. So I don't know if there's some jealousy here because Lucy just got jealous. This card might be speaking of jealousy. Believe it or not. Like somebody doesn't want to lose. Lose you, lose the situation, lose hope. They just don't want to lose. And I don't know what that's in reference to because it's reaching the whole mass of the whole masses, right? So it's not awful. This combo can be jealousy. This Nine of Cups could be jealousy. But not... I could see it now. Because the Nine of Cups sometimes can be arrogant. But you're not dealing with somebody arrogant. Well, they could be a little arrogant if they're a power player. But I don't think arrogant to you, if that makes sense. Because this person's very strategic. Once again, I'm back to the whole logistics. I don't know what that's about. Let's talk about the Hermit. You're dealing with somebody who's reliable and stable. It was the King of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck with the Hermit. It was the Hermit. Somebody that could be older, just somebody who's extremely smart, intellectual, right? Could be in the public eye, too. The Hermit's in the public eye, especially with the Six of Wands. But this is somebody who is determined to win someone over. This is not like ego, like bad ego. This is just somebody who's determined to be somewhat victorious with whatever this offer is. But it looks like the feminine goes on defense. Because I don't know if it's being offered out of jealousy. Like, I don't want to lose you. It can go down for it. In many different ways. Tell me about the Nine of Swords in the first place. Oh, I got an itchy back in my knee. Nine of Swords in the first place. You have the Chariot reversed. Because this hasn't happened yet. But something's about to be moved forward. It's the Chariot. You can't stop the Chariot. Can't stop the chariot. Not this freaking chariot. Look at it. And look how it just moved that one like way over here. Like it's almost like I did that and then I got pushed. See what I'm saying? You can't stop the chariot. This has to do with work commitment. This something. So I keep seeing commitment cards, but they're all reversed, so I'm not quite sure what that's pertaining to. It's going to be different for everyone, right? But this could be a Cancerian not stressing out as much. Someone's sleeping better. But I don't think that's what it's saying. Not the way that card just moved with that one, no way. This because it is something that can't be stopped. It's only a matter of time before all the reversals get flipped. In the two reversals down here, the clarifiers, they're major arcana. You don't control those, the universe does. And they're gonna flip them. For damn sure. Okay, so that was your read. Decision. But we saw that. We saw that anyway. Take your time. It's beautiful. I think this, you know, a lot of people say, oh, everyone says they're going to make a decision, but I don't know what it is. I remember, you know, going through my own spiritual thing and not feeling so connected to spirit or trying to figure out ways how to connect with spirit. Like, when this card came up, it used to stress me out, because what do you mean talking about a decision? I made a decision, I'm moving away from this, I'm going to take this, or something wasn't presented, yada, yada, yada. Like, I feel freaking chaos with you guys, and I remember that feeling. So my best advice would be, don't worry about this, there's a connection, right? Obviously, the two of you will figure it out together. Compromise. Because there's two of you, the connection, right? So to me, something's going to be presented to you. So don't stress out. Do what it is you do. Something will come in your direction, or somebody's going to want to talk about something where you guys will talk about it and decide. If you ask me, it almost looks like the two of you are going to decide together. So don't let that energy get the best of you. I really feel like within the next 4 days, the two of you are going to make a decision. And Six of Wands at the bottom of the deck, and it looks like it's going to be a good thing. Underneath that is the King of Swords. There's that air energy that I think you kind of both in. You both have to decide, right? But looks good. Okay. I love you guys. Have a fantastic day. Bye.